Hi, welcome. In this lecture, I'll be dealing with the sensory organs in insects. Insects have got number of sensory organs all over the body. With these sensory organs, they are able to see, hear, taste, touch, and smell the environment in which they are living. I usually compare the insects with human beings in order to showcase that insects are the most dominant creatures on this planet Earth. If you look at the location of sensory organs in case of human beings, most of these sensory organs are located on the face itself, right? Except skin, which is located all over the body. But insects have got varieties of sensory organs all over the body. Probably one of the important contributors for their success. Okay, so let us look at the structure and function of these sensory organs and see how actually they coordinate with the external environment and behave and act in response to the environmental stimuli. In fact, sensory receptors present on the insect body are of ectodermal in origin. So that means the epithelial cells in the exoskeleton are modified in order to perceive the external stimuli, which will be passed on to the axon, okay, and to the central nervous system, and where the information will be integrated and communicated to the effector organ through the motor neuron. So that means these sensory organs work in coordination with the central nervous system and they respond to the external environment. Okay, so that is possible because of the coordination of these sensory organs with the central nervous system. So, but these varieties of sensory organs located in different parts of the body perform different functions. Okay, so based on the functions these sensory organs perform, various type of receptors or sensilla have been identified on the insect body. So one type of receptors are mechanoreceptors. They detect movement, vibration, sound, and other mechanical disturbances. Chemoreceptors, they detect smell and taste. So they are called olfactory sensilla or gustatory sensilla. Photoreceptors, they detect the presence and types of light. Thermoreceptors detect temperature and heat. Hygroreceptors, okay, they respond to humidity changes. So that means there are varieties of receptors and these receptors perform different functions. So let us take one by one. Mechanoreceptors. These receptors found almost on any surface of the insect body and they are sensitive to mechanical stimuli such as contact, pressure and gravity. So that means they detect the touch, sound, vibration and proprioceptive cues. Proprioceptive cues are nothing but the positioning of the body parts or appendages in relation to gravity. Okay, so they are able to sense that they are whether they are climbing up, climbing down, flying. Okay, so all that is possible that because of these number of mechanoreceptors present on various parts of the body. But mechanoreceptor function is performed by different types of sensilla. Okay, so there are different types of sensilla on the insect body and all of them actually respond differently to touch, sound or vibration. Okay, so based on these, various type of sensilla have been identified. One is called trichoid sensilla, campaniform sensilla and chordotonal organs. What are these? Trichoid sensilla are setae or tactile ears, ear-like or setae-like structure present on the insect body and they are usually innervated by the sensory neuron. Okay, so they are present on antenna, mouth parts, legs, etc. where they respond to touch or movement of the body. So we know that there are a number of ears, okay, present on the insect body. So they in fact associated with the trichogen cell, okay, and they are movable because of the thermogen cell, right? So they in fact are modified in order to perceive the external stimuli, okay. So external stimuli which are mechanical disturbances, so hence they are actually mechanoreceptors. So one type of mechanoreceptors are trichoid sensilla, which are tactile ears. And the second type of sensilla are campaniform sensilla. So these campaniform sensilla are oval disc shaped sensilla. You can see here this cuticle is actually modified into dome shaped structure. Okay. And they are present on leg joints and wing bases where they respond to pressure changes and mechanical stresses. So these campaniform sensilla are usually located at the base of the locomotory organs. Okay. So in fact, they respond to pressure changes and mechanical stresses. Okay, those are the campaniform sensilla. And the third type of mechanoreceptors are carotonal organs. So these are specialized sensilla which are subcuticular in nature. Okay, so trichoid sensilla as well as campaniform sensilla, they are visible externally, whereas carotonal organs are not visible externally. That means there are no external sign of their presence, and they perceive to vibration or sound. Okay, so there are in fact different type of carotonal organ. One common type of carotonal organ are tympanum. Okay, tympanal organs. So we know that tympanum, for example, on the long arm, in case of long arm grasshoppers, they are located in the fore tibia. Or in case of short arm grasshopper, for example, they are located on the first abdominal segment. So if you just externally look for the such organs, they do not possess any the sign of external presence. So these carotonal organs do not have any sign of their external presence, but they perform very important function. Okay, so they perceive the sound. Similarly, Johnston organs, which are located in the pedicel of this second antennal segment, right? So pedicel. So these carotonal organs perceive the sound. Okay. So then the second type of receptors present are the chemoreceptors. So these sensilla are receptors involved in identification of chemicals. Okay. So they are present in several parts of the body, like mouth parts, foregut, antennae, tibiae, and tarsi of legs, even ovipositor. Okay. May be very important contributor for the success. You may ask me, why these chemoreceptors are present on ovipositor? Usually, chemoreceptors are very important for in order to sense the taste of the food, okay, or smell the food. But they are located even on the ovipositor and even the legs. Okay, especially in case of housefly, these receptors are found on the legs itself. Okay, if a housefly sits on some food, with these sensory organs, they are able to perceive that whether it is food or not. Similarly, ovipositor, for example, various insects, when they touch these ovipositor on a leaf surface, a host plant surface, they are able to sense it whether it is a host plant or not, whether the offsprings will survive it or not by feeding on that particular host plant. Okay, so that is the importance of these chemoreceptors. So in fact, these receptors are able to perceive the chemical which are in the gaseous state or in the liquid state. So they are called olfactory sensilla or gustatory sensilla. So these sensilla may be uniporous. So these uniporous sensilla are called usually contact chemoreceptors. They are able to respond to the taste. They perceive the taste. Whereas the multiporous sensilla respond to the smell. That means they perceive the smell or odors. Okay. Then the third and very important sensilla present on the insect body are photoreceptors. So they perceive the light. The insects usually perceive the light with the wavelength range from 300 to 700 nanometer, big wavelength. So these photoreceptors have a visual pigment called rhodopsin. So which actually convert the light into electrical as well as the chemical substance through which the information will be communicated and reaches to the central nervous system and act. And there are three types of photoreceptors on the insect body. One is compound eyes, dorsal oscilli, and lateral oscilli, which are also called stemmata. So let us take one by one. Compound eyes. Okay. So if you look at most of the insects, they possess compound eyes. If there are no compound eyes, they are actually blind. Of course, there are a number of insects which are blind. And if you observe closely, you will find large number of hexagonal units in each of those eyes. Okay. So in fact, insect eyes are called compound eyes because they possess number of lenses. And each of these lenses are called facets. Okay. Or externally they are called facets. And each of those hexagonal units, in fact, move internally. They are, in fact, internal structures as well, and represented internally as well. And they are individually called ommatidia. Okay, ommatidia. So externally, they are represented by facet. So that means that individual hexagonal unit is called ommatidium. Okay, it's singular, whereas ommatidia is plural. So externally, they are represented by a dome-shaped structure called facet. Okay. So the number of ommatidia in a compound eye, in a insect compound eye, varies from species to species. There may be very few in case of insects which in, live in places where there is no light, for example, in cryptic habitat like silverfish. Okay, so where in these insects, very few number of ometidium may be present. Whereas very fast flying insect like a dragonfly, where single compound eye may consist of 30,000 ometidia. So it varies from species to species. So if you take a cross section of that particular compound eye, you'll find a number of ometidia. Okay, so externally, they are consist of a cuticular lens called corneal lens. So behind that, you'll find the crystalline cone. And in fact, there will be secondary pigment cells, okay, which in fact secretes the rhabdom, which is the light sensitive pigment, which convert that light into electrical substance, stimuli, and that will be passed on to the central nervous system. So through the axon. So let us look at the structure of these compound eyes or ometidia and see how the image is in fact formed by the insects which see particular object. Okay, so if you take the cross section of a particular ometidia, say for example, this single ometidia. So it is a extension, whatever we see from the external hexagonal unit, it runs as an anatomical structure. So in fact, this entire ometidia is divided into two parts. One is called optic part and sensory part. So what is this? This optic part in fact consists of a cuticular lens called corneal lens. Okay, so which runs internally into a cone-shaped structure called crystalline cone, which is in fact secreted by the Semper cells. Okay, so this crystalline cone is covered by the primary pigment cell. Okay, this is the primary pigment cell. So this optic part consists of corneal lens, crystalline cone covered by the primary pigment cell. Whereas the sensory part consists of number of retinular cells. In fact, it varies from species to species. Generally, 6 to 8 retinular cells are found, which are covered by the secondary pigment cell. Okay, so these retinular cells are covered by the secondary pigment cell. So in fact, these retinular cells and secondary pigment cells secrete rhabdom. So very important compound, which is the light sensitive pigment, which converts the, whatever the light which is received from the optic part. So that means the function of the optic part is to gather the light, receive the light, and the sensory part is to convert that light into electrical energy. Let us look at in detail, because if you understand the structure of ometidia and its function, it is very easy to understand how the image is formed by the different group of insects. So this optic part is in fact gathers the light, okay, which consists of cuticular lens called corneal lens and crystalline cone covered by the primary pigment cell. So the function of this optic part is to gather the light, whereas the function of this sensory part is to convert this light into electrical energy. So what is this sensory part consists of? So it consists of 6 to 8 visual cells called retinular cells. So these are the cells covered by the secondary pigment cells, which collectively secrete the rhabdom. Okay, so whatever the light which is received will be converted into electrical energy and passed on to the neurons and reaches to the central nervous system. Okay, so let us look at how the image is formed. Say for example, a compound eye is there in an insect. Now there are two compound eyes in fact. And whenever the insect is seeing some object, say for example, this is the object, and which falls on the ometidia, say the cuticular lens, because of the presence of these primary pigment cell. Okay, so this is very much important. Because of the presence of these primary pigment cell, whatever the light which falls on that particular ometidia will not pass into the next ometidia. Okay, so it reaches to the rhabdom. Okay, where whatever that each ometidia is seeing, that particular object will be formed, that image is formed on the rhabdom. Okay, so this is the object which is visible to that particular ometidia, that image is formed here. Whereas the other ometidia sees a part of that object, which will be formed here. Like that, each of these ometidia form the image. As a result of that, you can see this broken image is formed on the rhabdom. Okay, so it is a mosaic image which is formed on the rhabdom, but it is not a complete image. But they form a mosaic image, but a very distinct image. Okay, so here, whatever the object they are seeing will be formed, the image is formed, but the image is actually a composite image, but a very distinct image is formed on the retina. Okay. So yes, because of these primary pigment cells, the light will not pass, the object, whatever they're seeing, will not pass through the next omatidia. Hence, each of these omatidia sees that particular image, that part of that image, and that image is formed on the rhabdom. As a result, a composite image is formed on the rhabdom. Hope you understood. So, but there is a problem. So, whatever we discussed is actually the image formation in the light adapted or the diurnal insects. But there are varieties of insects, right? Many of them are active during day and many of them are active at night. Okay, so they are those insects which are active at night are called nocturnal insects, right? So let us see how the image is formed. So I'll repeat once again. In case of diurnal insects, what happens? Whatever the image they see, each of these omatidia see a small part image is formed on the rhabdom, which is called composite image. Okay, so those eyes which are adapted to day condition, diurnal condition, are called opposition eyes, are also called photopic eyes. Why this image is not moved to the next omatidia? This is because of these primary pigment cells. I have colored here. Okay, so because of the presence of these primary pigment cell, the light will not pass into the adjacent omatidia. Okay, which happens in case of nocturnal insects. And the rhabdom, you see here, this is also I have colored. This rhabdom is found from the base of primary pigment cell to the end of basal lamina. Okay, probably we will understand once we discuss what happens in case of nocturnally adapted eyes. Okay, nocturnal insects. So those insects where the eyes perform differently, the function of these eyes actually different, which are called superposition eye, which are also called photopic eyes. So let us see what happens. Here you see these primary pigment cells are absent in case of nocturnal insects. These primary pigment cells are absent in case of superposition eyes. And the rhabdom in case of light adapted eyes, which is present throughout the sensory part from the base of primary pigment cell to the basal lamina. This rhabdom is present only at the base of basal lamina, which is not extended to the complete length. Okay, that is the difference between the opposition eye and superposition eye. Okay, so let us see how the image is formed. So whenever these insects actually, nocturnal insects, see a particular object, say light, which pass to the, you see here, they are passed to the next omatidia as well because of absence of this primary pigment cell. Okay, as a result of that, a complete image is formed. They are able to see the complete image. Okay, whatever the object they are seeing, a complete image is formed on the rhabdom, but it is not distinct. It is indistinct and blurred. Okay, so whereas the image formed may be part, but a distinct image is formed in case of opposition eye or photopic eyes, whereas here indistinct image is formed or it may be blurred in case of superposition eyes. Okay, so let us look at what is the major difference. Rhabdom is extended from crystalline cone on the basement membrane in case of opposition image, as well as primary pigment cells are present. Whereas in case of superposition eye, rhabdom is confined to basal arc only and primary pigment cells are absent. Okay, because of these two differences, in fact, the image formed is different in case of diurnal insects as well as in case of nocturnal insects. Okay, so probably I'll repeat. In case of opposition eyes, rhabdom is extended from crystalline cone and the basement membrane, whereas here the rhabdom is confined to the basal arc of omatidia. Primary pigment cells are present. Here they are absent. Light cannot pass to the adjacent cell. Light can pass to the adjacent cell because of primary pigment cells. Omatidia does not form the entire field of view. Omatidia forms a complete image. Here a mosaic image is formed, but it is distinct. Whereas the image formed is indistinct and blurred in case of light adapted or the nocturnal insects. Okay, so that is the difference between the image formation in the diurnal insects and the nocturnal insects. So what are the major functions of compound eyes? They perceive the light, they perceive shape, movement, detect polarization pattern of sunlight, they discriminate wavelength range from UV to yellow. So let us see the second type of photoreceptors present in the insects. ocelli. So generally they should be called as dorsal ocelli. Okay, as they are usually present on the dorsal region, they should be called dorsal ocelli. But most insect possess these ocelli. That's why they are generally termed as ocelli. So if you are talking about ocelli, means it is dorsal ocelli, because there are other type of ocelli called lateral ocelli, which are restricted only to larvae. Okay, so what are these? They are found in adults of most insects and also immatures of hemimetabolous insects. Okay, almost all the adults will have the dorsal ocelli, but they are also found in immatures of the nymphs of hemimetabolous insects. Number usually varies from 2 to 3 if they are present. Okay, so very rarely we find one ocelli, generally 2 and 3. Okay, so like these, they are positioned with the dorsal region. And they are not independent organs and never occur in species that lack compound eyes. Okay, if these compound eyes are not there, these ocelli will not be there. Okay, that is the very important thing. Differ in compound eyes in having single corneal lens. Okay, this is the structure. Okay, so they have got single corneal lens, and they are immediately below their abdomen will be there, secreted by the retinal cells, and they takes the light and convert it into electrical energy and pass it on to the axon. So generally absent in wingless forms. Okay, they become vestigial, of course, because when there is no need of movement, okay, flight, so definitely they become vestigial through the process of evolution. So the main function of these dorsal ocelli is to perceive the light intensity. So the other type of photoreceptors are lateral ocelli, which are also called stemmata. What are these? Okay, in fact, they are positioned in the lateral region of the larva, caterpillar. If I say caterpillar means, or the grub means, they are called holometabolous insects. So lateral ocelli or stemmata are the sole visual organs of holometabolous larvae. Okay, we know that endopterygotan insects. Okay, I'm talking of the larvae or the immatures of endopterygotan insects. Okay, so endopterygotan insects larvae or the immatures do not possess these compound eyes. Okay, whereas they possess in the lateral side, they possess number of these ocelli. Okay, like dorsal ocelli we are discussing, number of lateral ocelli are present in the, they are positioned in the lateral region, and they perceive the light again. Okay, so these are the sole visual organs of larvae or the immatures of holometabolous insects. Except, okay, within these holometabolous insects, they are absent in larvae of fleas, Siphonoptera, and Apocryton, Hymenoptera. For example, bees, okay, grubs, young ones of bees are called grubs, they do not possess these lateral ocelli. Okay, except these, so most holometabolous insect immatures, they possess lateral ocelli. Their number again varies from 2 to 12. Okay, there may be 6 this side, 6 that side. They are similar to dorsal ocelli, but they have a crystalline cone. Okay, you can see a crystalline cone under the cornea with few sensory rod. Okay, so that is the additional character if you compare with the dorsal ocelli. Okay, so again, they perceive the light intensity. The difference is that they are found only in the holometabolous larvae. Okay, so in this sensory organ class, we discussed that the presence of various organs. With these sensory organs, they are able to perceive the smell, taste, ear, touch, and able to see the environment. Insects possess mechanoreceptors, chemoreceptors, photoreceptors, thermoreceptors, hygroreceptors, like that. There are varieties of receptors. There are the very important organs are compound eyes, which are the principal visual organs of most insects and made up of a number of ommatidia. Some insect eyes are adjusted to diurnal activity, which are called apposition eyes or photopic eyes. And some ommatidia are adjusted to nocturnal activity and are called superposition eyes or scotopic eyes. Dorsal ocelli occurs in most adult insects and also nymphs of hemimetabolous insects, whereas the lateral ocelli are the sole visual organs of holometabolous insects, holometabolous larvae. Few questions. Ocelli are useful to perceive. Dash sensilla respond to sound vibration. The visual pigment present in compound eye is. Dash type of eye is present in nocturnal insects, photopic, right? The visual organ present in immature holometabolous insect is. Okay, these are the few fill in the blanks. One question which I am not included in my lecture so far is the what is Colopidia, okay, which is in fact found in pedicel, that means concerned with gastrointestinal organ. Look for that. Okay, so thank you very much. If there are any specific question, you can post below or you can email me as well. Thank you very much.